Hey guys, welcome to this week's studio chat. As always, please don't forget to leave a comment below or a question below. I'd love to hear from you. And today we're talking about complementary colors and why a lot of this is totally bogus and quite honestly foolishness. So there's been this idea that has been pervasive for the last couple of hundred years. We've got the color wheel and we've got the Roy G. Biv going around in the circle, where humans have attempted to take a portion of the visible spectrum, the visible spectrum, and they like to put it in this predefined, nice, perfect circle, and then somehow declare that, hey, if you mix opposites on the wheel, you'll get neutral, because they're located opposite each other. And that is 100% bogus, okay? You don't believe me? Try it for yourself. Do what your art teacher probably taught you or you learned somewhere a long time ago. Take red and green. They're supposed to be complements, right? Mix them together. I can guarantee you, you will not get black or you will not get a neutral gray. It's not going to happen, okay? And then some of you might be a little bit wiser and say, well, red and green technically aren't complements because that's the old-fashioned color wheel with red, yellow, and blue as the primaries, and we know that's totally bogus. And you might say, well, I'm going to work from my magenta, cyan, yellow color wheel, and then I'll find complements there, opposites on that wheel, and then you'll mix them together, and then you'll quickly find out that that's totally bogus too. And without getting deep into the science, I mean, I love science. I love the science of color. I love the mathematics, and just I love knowing just enough to be a better painter. And then that's always the focus. I am never going to go completely deep into the weeds and then forget about painting, because man, at the end of the day, it's all about making better paintings. And I can feel a rant coming. There's just way too many people on the internet who love to hang out in forums and bicker over, I call them hair splitters. People love to argue minutia. Right. Well, actually, this is the cause of that. And well, actually, and you know what? You go look at their paintings and they're horrible. Most of these people are boring as heck and they produce crappy artwork. Anyway, all right, let me give you the quick answer here. Why compliments don't work. Whew, that was some rant. All right. So let's take a tube of cad yellow. Here's a gambling cad yellow. Put it nice and close there. All right. So what is yellow? Yellow is all happening in your brain. There's certain wavelengths that are coming off this color and they're going into your eye, down the optic nerve. Your brain is making the color up, okay? So this idea that it's often taught that this color only reflects yellow is totally bogus, because if it did, if you mixed it with any other color and that color only reflected, you would pretty much get a black anytime you mix any other colors. So what's happening here is this yellow is reflecting a broad spectrum of the visual spectrum. So it's actually reflecting reds, it's reflecting greens, it's reflecting yellows, it's reflecting oranges, it's reflecting a broader spectrum than just the yellow. And all the other colors are doing similar things. So when you mix them together, whatever is common between those two colors, between the spectrums, that is the color that you are seeing. So it's complicated. They're not like machines in which they can detect exact wavelengths. They're just responding. And a lot of times what looks like yellow might have a little bit different power distribution curve. I hate to use a technical curve term, but what part of the spectrum it's reflecting, we're not that sensitive to it. So if it's reflecting a little bit more of yellow, a little bit more of green, this and that, your eyes will just see it as yellow. And we see it as yellow, and then we mix it with another color, and sometimes we're shocked at what happens. And that's because we cannot physically detect all the nuances of the wavelength. We just see enough. And there are machines that can read these things, but we can't. If you put red and green light together, your brain cannot tell the difference between pure yellow light and red and green together. We are just not sensitive enough beings to detect these things. And so this idea that the color wheel is set up in a perfect circle and you can mix opposites and get a neutral right in the middle, totally bogus. I know I did go a little bit in the weeds with the science of that. And all you have to know is that doesn't work. So, I mean, this is, again, why working with grays and working with neutrals is a very powerful way of working. People who say, I don't paint with black and stuff like that, that's nonsense. Everyone should be working with black and white and grays, a full set of neutrals, with their paints, because this is how you effectively and more predictably reduce the chroma of the colors. This is how you reduce the intensity. Okay, this notion that, well, I'm just going to take all my colors and mix to opposite parts of the wheel, and it's nuts. And some people even want you to take each of your colors, mix it with another color to just randomly see what you get. Okay, I've seen that in books. There's some really, really famous painters who advocate that. I'm not going to call anybody out on this, but there are plenty of famous painters who do that. Take all of your colors, mix it with all of your colors, and see the different grays you get. Okay, all these different neutrals. Well, first of all, they're not pure neutral. Second of all, it's totally redundant. Like a very large portion of the complements and the mixing colors with opposites, they're redundant, and it's nonsense. It's like hocus pocus. So embrace the use of neutrals. Understand that complements do not work, okay? And if you don't believe me, I challenge you to take any known complements, mix them, and you're going to see you do not get a neutral, okay? So just some food for thought. And we'll talk soon.